When Ramana, played by Mahesh Babu, was a little boy, his mother, Vaira Vasundhara, played by Ramya Krishna, abandoned him. Ultimately, Vasundhara remarries after separating from her husband and son for reasons that are only known to her. As an adult, Ramana is compelled by his influential grandfather, Venkataswami, played by Prakash Raj, to completely cut relations with his mother. Whenever I see a collaboration between Mahesh Babu and Trivikram Srinivas, I expect quality films like the 2000 film Atadu and the 2010 film Kaleja, and while I did enjoy parts of the film, this is nowhere near his best work. This film overall is more like a variation of the 2005 Malayalam film Rajamanikyam, as the concept is similar but with different execution. If you have seen the trailer, then you pretty much know what you're getting. This movie is not aiming for quality and in-depth storytelling like RRR. This is a pure time-pass entertainer with a familiar plot. Mahesh Babu is the highlight of the film. He carries this film. He makes even the dull scenes work and his energy is contagious. Fans of Mahesh Babu won't be disappointed. Prakash Raj and Ramya Krishna are just going with the flow, as it's nothing noteworthy. Srileela does not have a huge role in this film. She is just eye candy, but her dance sequences are good. The romantic subplot is there just for the sake of it, as it lacks any emotional impact. She does make me curious, however, as to how the scenes involving her would have played out had it been Pooja Hegde playing the role, since she was initially cast as the lead actress, but she opted out from the venture due to her schedule conflicts. Prior to Pooja Hegde's withdrawal, Srileela was originally contracted to play the second actress role. However, Meenakshi Chaudhary took over the second actress role and Srileela assumed the main role. Meenakshi has so little to do in this film and her contribution to the story is so minuscule that cutting her portions out would affect nothing. She is present and that's all. The same can be said for Jagapati Babu and most of the supporting cast. There are cameo appearances from Purna in the song Kuchi Marata Petti and Ajay as Gelatin Babji. While Ajay does a good job as Gelatin Babji, Purna doesn't add anything of value to the song. And speaking of songs, they are enjoyable if you're watching them separately from the film. As a part of the film, it lacks the emotional connection. The action scenes are excellent, and I enjoyed those parts the most. The way it was choreographed, while nothing new, felt very anime-like. Even Manoj Paramahamsa's camera work is really outstanding, particularly the continuous follow-through shots. And that's all I have to say about this film. The collaboration between Mahesh Babu and Trivikram Srinivas in this film delivers an enjoyable cinematic experience, but it falls short of the high expectations set by their previous collaborations such as Atadu and Kaleja. I would recommend you pass on the theater experience for this one and give it a watch once it hits OTT. That's my suggestion, but the choice is entirely yours. This was my opinion on Guntur Karam, and I'll see you in the next video. It's kind of funny that the more we pass time, the more we need to set them rewind. And 19 was the year I had to leave you, but now I'm seeing all the signs. Is this